أهلا بيكم في المحاضرة الرابعة والأخيرة من كورس اللغة الإنجليزية لمعادلة كلية تجارة جامعة القاهرة لسنة 2020. الكورس تحضير أستاذ دكتور أماني وجيه وقراءة هبة بكري من قسم اللغة الإنجليزية بكلية الآداب جامعة القاهرة. النهاردة هنتكلم عن grammar exercises, grammar lessons and exercises. يمكن من أصعب الحاجات اللي بتقابلنا دايماً في الجرامر التنسز أو الأزمنة. خلينا نبص على أبسط الأزمنة اللي ممكن إن احنا نستخدمها وإمتى بنستخدمها. simple present, simple past, simple future. كلمة simple معناها بسيط، يعني إيه بسيط؟ يعني حاجة موجودة على طول، حاجة مش شغالة دلوقتي وهتخلص، لا حاجة ثابتة. بمعنى when I say it usually rains every day here, I'm talking about a habit or something that happens all the time. الترجمة هتبقى مثلا عادة بتمطر كل يوم هنا، فدي حاجة عادة موجودة على طول منذ الأزل وهتكمل معانا إلى الأبد، ما هيش مرتبطة بتوقيت معين، ومش معناها ان هي لسه هتخلص انها هتخلص في وقت معين او انها ابتدت في وقت معين، لكنها حاجة موجودة على المدى من زمان ودلوقتي والبكرة وعلى طول. It smells very delicious in the kitchen. ريحة المطبخ حلوة. ريحة المطبخ tasty او في ريحة حاجة حلوة في المطبخ، دي حاجة ثابتة، مش حاجة كده شويتين انها هتبقى في ريحة وبعدين هتقف، لا هي انا دلوقتي I can smell it. We generally sing songs all together. احنا عادة عموما بنغني الاغاني مع بعض، دي برضو عادة. We go to a gallery every Sunday. بنروح المعرض كل حد، برضو بنتكلم في habit في عادة. Does he write an email؟ هل هو بيكتب ايميل عموما؟ the sun rises at the east. الشمس بتشرق من الشرق، دي scientific fact. It doesn't rain here in the summer. برضو this is another scientific fact. We cook every day. بنطبخ كل يوم. We go to the gym club together. بنروح النادي مع بعض او yes الجيم كلاب. So I use the simple present mainly for two purposes: scientific facts and habits, things that happen all the time or things that when I want to explain a state او عايزة اتكلم عن حالة دلوقتي، لما اقول مثلا it is hot، الدنيا حر. It is hot. ما هياش حاجة شغالة وهتقف زي action مثلا، زي لما أقول it is raining now. هي المطرة شغالة من شوية وهتخلص كمان شوية، لكن لما أقول مثلا it rains in winter معناها عموما المطرة في مصر بتبقى في الشتاء. Okay. So this is the simple present. Then I have the simple past. The simple past is very simple. We talk about something that happened in the past and ended and finished and is completed. George came home very late last night. امبارح جورج جه البيت متأخر، جه خاص. بنتكلم في action في فعل انتهى بالفعل. I forgot my wallet. انا نسيت المحفظة بتاعتي، نسيتها خلاص، مش لسه هنساها ولا بنساها، هو دلوقتي شويتين هبطل انساها، هي حاجة ثابتة وحاجة في الماضي. He had a dog last year. كان عنده كلب السنة اللي فاتت. Last year I traveled to Germany. Two boys played with a ball. An old lady walked with her cat. A nurse brought a little girl baby. So I have here actions that started and finished and ended in the past. As for the simple future, we are talking about something that will happen in the future. Okay, what about the grammar of these tenses? How do I write it? The simple present tense is very, very easy. You just use the base form of the verb, okay, the infinitive of the verb, plus s if we are talking about he, she, or it. So I say, I play football. He looks at her and smiles. The train arrives at 6 o'clock. So here we are talking about a fact, I play football, a fact or a habitual activity, something that happens all the time. He looks at her and smiles. Present activity for stories. يعني اللي أنا شايفاه قدامي دلوقتي إن هو باصص لها. He looks at her and smiles. The train arrives at 6 o'clock. This is a scheduled future activity. The simple present. It states repeated actions. My friend often draws nice posters. صديقي أو صديقتي عادة بترسم أو بيرسم بوسترات حلوة. دي حاجة ثابتة، حاجة عادة متكررة. It states things in general, like the sun rises in the east. Some things like scientific facts, water boils at 100 degrees. It states fixed arrangements or scheduled events. The plane flies to London every Monday. Again, this is a schedule, this is a habit, حاجة بتتكرر وحاجة معروفة. احنا عارفين امتى البلين هتطلع. It flies every Monday. أو the train leaves at 6 o'clock. القطار هيغادر الساعة 6. It states sequence of actions in the present. First I get up, then I have breakfast. Again, if I'm asking you about your habits, what do you usually do in the morning? You say first I get up, then I have breakfast. I do this all the time. signal words or key words، كلمات لما اشوفها اعرف ان انا لازم استخدم ال present simple. every day، كل يوم. often، عادة. always، دائما. sometimes، احيانا. never، ابدا. form، infinitive or the base as we said before. and the s if it is he, she, or it. I always listen to music. My sister always listens to music. My friends don't listen to classical music. My mother doesn't listen to classical music. Do you listen to music? Does Heba listen to music? So it's very easy. You just use the verb as it is. نستخدم الverb زي ما هو أو بنضيف له s في حالة he, she, or it. ولو question الverb auxiliary or helping verb will take the tense like does Heba listen to music and in the negative as well my mother doesn't listen to music. Let's answer this exercise. I'll give you some minutes for you. Please pause the video and try to answer it on your own. Okay, the three girls play music in harmony. She not read the email today. She not write the email today. She takes s, right? And because this is a negative, then it will take does. So she does not write the email today. Carpenters use wood to make furniture. Carpenters use. زي ما هي. My friend rides his motorbike every day. I like pizza. He never drinks Bad driving causes many accidents. At what time does the bank هنا it right يبقى تاخد s does the bank open. Vegetarians do not eat meat. The kitten jumps all over the plates. So the present simple tense is very very extremely easy. You just leave the verb as it is or add s if it is he, she or it. Now the past simple or the simple past, simply something that a completed activity or a completed action in the past. I played the guitar, Julie sang a lullaby. It happened in the past. It states an action finished in the past. I visited Ismailia last week. It states a series of completed actions in the past. First, I got up, then I had breakfast yesterday. And there are signal words as well, or keywords such as yesterday, last week, a month ago, in 2002. Form with regular verbs, infinitive plus ed, with irregular verbs, second column of the table of the irregular verbs. ازاي بنكون simple past؟ بناخد الفيرب زي ما هو نحط له ed، ده في الريجولر فيربس، اغلب الافعال بيحصل معاها كده، لكن في برضو افعال كتيره irregular بيبقى ليها تصريفات مختلفه زي go، the past of go is went، right؟ واحيانا بيبقى نفس الفيرب زي ما هو run، no sorry something like what يعني run ran for example it will be ran not runned right let it stays as it is so sometimes the verb stay as it is sometimes it changes and sometimes we just add an ed this is about the form Here are some examples about regular verbs. I played football. They played football. He played football. We did not play football. Did she play football? And here are examples of irregular verbs like the verb go. To go will be in the past went. I went to the club. They went to the club. He went to the club. We did not go to the club. Did she go to the club? And you have the table of irregular verbs in your course book. You can also find it in any good dictionary at the end of the dictionary and of course online. Let's answer this exercise together. Put the verbs between brackets in the past form. When they went to the cafe, they order some sandwiches and tea. طيب انا لو ما قاليش ان انا احطها في الباست فورم ايش عرفني ان this verb should be in the past لان نص الجملة الاولاني في الباست when they went لما راحوا الكافيه يبقى بعد كده طبيعي هيبقى برضو في الباست when they went to the cafe they ordered They ordered some sandwiches. Last summer, I went to Alexandria. In 2001, they bought this house. يبقى أنا في أول جملة عندي النص الأولاني في الباست. في تاني جملة عندي last summer as a signal word or a key word. في تالت جملة عندي in 2001. برضو this is another signal. Word or keyword معناها انها تبقى في الباست. In number 4 the secretary deleted the file yesterday before the meeting. Here the word is yes yesterday. The weather was nice last Monday. He did not need your help last Wednesday. When did they arrive yesterday? The policeman caught the thief last night. Who cleaned the house yesterday morning? It was hot yesterday, so I took off my coat. يبقى زي ما احنا شايفين دايما بيبقى عندي كلمة بتعرفني زمن الجملة دي في present, past ولا في future. The simple future. There are two future forms used in most conversations. The future with will and the future with going to. The main difference between the two forms is that going to is used for plans and intentions made before the moment of speaking, and the will to speak about the future at the moment of speaking. طيب لما احب اتكلم عن المستقبل البسيط او السهل خالص، يعني ابسط حاجة هستخدمها عن المستقبل هي will plus the base form or the infinitive of the verb. Will plus the base form. So I will dance tomorrow, David will be late, and so on. But another way also is to use going to. خلينا الأول نشوف will. The future simple tense is often called will because we make the future simple tense with the modal auxiliary will. The form, the structure of the future simple tense is subject plus will plus main verb plus object. Mariam will learn French. Mariam won't learn French. إيه كلمة won't دي؟ This is short for will not أو اختصار ل will not. بعد عايزة أقول will not هقولها بسرعة، هقول won't learn English. يعني مش عايزة أو مش هتتعلم فرنساوي. Question form هنبتدي ب will. Will Mariam learn French? And will here is an auxiliary. Yes, it's a modal verb. Uses no plan. We use a future simple tense when there is no plan or decision to do something before we speak. يعني أنا قاعد دلوقتي كده وقررت I'll go and see who's ringing the bell. مثلا الجرس ضرب وأنا هقوم أشوف I'll go and get it. أنا هشوف مين. I'll go and answer the phone. أنا هرد على التليفون دلوقتي. ده قرار أنا أخدته دلوقتي أكيد مش مخططة له من كتير. لكن going to بستخدمها دايما في التخطيط. خلينا برضو لسه في will. يبقى أول حاجة will قرار مفاجئ. برضو بستخدم will في البريدكشن أو التنبؤ بناء على حاجة قدامي. It will rain tomorrow. الدنيا مغيمة ف definitely كده شكلها it will rain tomorrow. With verb to be we can use the future simple tense even if we have a firm plan or decision before speaking. I'll be in London tomorrow. I'm going shopping. I won't be very long. Will you be at work tomorrow? So here is an illustration, an explanation of the differences between will and going to. Will expresses future actions decided at the moment of speaking. I'll have salad now. جه الويتر بيسألني هتاخدي ايه فأقول انا هاخد سالد. ما ينفعش اقول I'm going to take salad كأن انا مخططة ليها، لا ده قرار انا خدته دلوقتي. يبقى I'll have salad or I will have salad now. Express a prediction based on personal opinions or experiences. I think United will win the game. I think الأهلي will win the game. I think الزمالك will win the game. Express a future fact. The sun will rise tomorrow. دي حاجة برضو يعني معروفة مش محتاجة تخطيط، هي هتحصل على طول. Will rise tomorrow. Going to express future plans decided before the moment of speaking. I'm going to visit my aunt next Friday. أنا مخططة إن أنا بالفعل هزور عمتي أو خالتي الجمعة الجاي. Express a prediction based on present evidence. Look at those black clouds. It's going to rain. It's going to rain. Prediction based on evidence, not opinion or experience. Express something is about to happen. Get back. The bomb is going to explode. القنبلة هتنفجر. however still برضو انا ممكن استخدم الاتنين مكان بعض، بس الاكيد ان في حاجات ما ينفعش اقول فيها going to، زي مثلا ان انا اقول I'm going to answer the phone، I will على طول. okay so the differences as simple the difference is as simple as that. will بنستخدمها لما اكون قررت هعمل حاجة دلوقتي، going to هستخدمها مع حاجة انا already مخططة لها وعارفة ان هعمل ايه. يعني لما حد يسألني هتشتغل ايه هقول بعد التخرج مثلا هستخدم will ولا going to. going to لان دي حاجة انا مخططة لها. well I'm going to start at a firm، هبتدي في شركة مثلا. او well I'm going to start my own business، انا هبتدي الشغل بتاعي، business بتاعي. okay So the future with going to is used to express events you have already planned in the future and your intentions for the future. We sometimes also use the present continuous for planned events in the near future. We are going to make the presentation next week. دي حاجة احنا مخططين لها. ازاي بنعمله؟ بنكتبه I am going to subject plus to be plus going to plus verb. I'm going to attend the meeting. I'm not going to visit Rome next year. Where am I going to stay? Choose the correct form. Peter has been learning a lot recently. I'm sure he's going to pass. He'll pass his exam. Which is the correct form? Peter has been learning a lot recently. بيذاكر بقاله كتير. فأنا قررت ان هو هينجح، ولا انا شايفه ان هو بما انه بيذاكر فهي is going to pass. Look at that boy hanging on that tree. He's going to fall off. Will fall off the tree. ده حدث حصل دلوقتي حالا. بقول لك بص الولد اللي متعلق على الشجره ده هيقع. هل هستخدم going to اللي فيها تخطيط، ولا will على طول اللي هي في ساعتها من غير تخطيط؟ Why are you putting on your clothes? Because I'm going to take the dog for a walk. ولا I will take the dog for a walk. هي حاجة أنا عاملة حسابي عليها ولا جت فجأة؟ I hope everything is going to be alright. ولا will be alright. So the answers are Peter has been learning a lot recently. I'm sure he's going to pass. لأنه مخطط لده، هو بيذاكر بقاله كتير، فأنا أقدر إني أتنبأ بناء على الإيفيدنس اللي قدامي، الدليل اللي قدامي إن هو هينجح في الامتحان بتاعه. Look at that boy hanging on that tree. He will fall off the tree. هيقع خلاص، هو حاجة شفتها، هو أكيد مش مخطط إن هو يقع، صح؟ دي حاجة حصلت فجأة دلوقتي، هتحصل فجأة دلوقتي قدام من غير تخطيط. يبقى will fall off the tree. fall off the tree يعني يقع من على الشجرة. Why are you putting on your clothes? Because I'm going to take the dog for a walk. أنا لابسة ومتشيكة ومحضرة نفسي ومحضرة الدوج، يبقى أكيد دي حاجة مخططة لها، يبقى I'm going to take the dog for a walk. Finally, I hope everything will be alright. احنا مش لسه بقى هنخطط، احنا بنقول نتمنى ان الدنيا تبقى، ان الامور هتبقى على ما يرام. اوكي ما فيهاش تخطيط يعني. اوكي is it clear? So if I want to talk about the future I either use going to, am going to or verb to be, going to and then the verb, or I use will and the verb. Will I use it when it is something that is sudden, unpredicted or something that is unplanned. While if it is something planned, I use going to. She bring some chocolates to the party last week. I have a signal word here. Where is it? Yes, last week. So what kind of tense should I use? Yes. Past simple. She brought some chocolates to the party last week. I Hear a new song on the radio last night. Again, where is the signal word? فين الكلمة اللي هعرف منها الزمن بتاعي؟ Last night. So it will be I heard a new song on the radio last night. I read 3 books last week. Again, last week. It's in the past, right? الأسبوع اللي فات. So it will be I read. It is pronounced read, but it is spelled R-E-A-D. So is it a regular or an irregular verb? Yes, it's an irregular verb. I read 3 books last week. They spoke or speak or will speak French to the waitress. First, I don't have any signal word that say that this is in the past, right? يبقى early present أو future. I don't know. ما أقدرش أقول إن هما هيكلموا فرنساوي للويترس. It doesn't really make sense. يبقى هستخدم إيه؟ ال present simple لحاجة أنا شايفاها بتحصل قدامي دلوقتي. They speak French to the waitress. He understand during the class. But now he doesn't understand. أنا بقول هو فهم أثناء المحاضرة أو الحصة، لكن دلوقتي هو مش فاهم. يبقى هو فهم في الباست ولا بيفهم وفاهم ولا مش ولا future. Of course it will be in the past. He understood during the class. Number 6. I forget or forgot or will forget to buy some milk before going home. أنا هنسى ولا أنا نسيت؟ Yes, I forgot. I forgot to buy some milk before going home. She had a baby last June because last June, it's in the past. Very clear. And the signal word. You lost your keys last week. Again, last week. يبقى أنا التنسز بالنسبة لي سهلة جدا، لأن دايما هيبقى عندي كلمة تعرفني أنا في أي زمن، إذا كان ال present, past or future. They usually swim 500 meters because we said we use the present simple with frequency adverbs, and if I'm talking about a habit, عادة بعملها، هما عادة بيعوموا 500 متر. I'm going to give my mother a book for her birthday. طبعا هي هنا مش باين إذا كان present ولا future, past ولا future. هي أكيد مش present. Okay. لأن ده هيبقى معناه إن I give my mother a book for her birthday، معناه إن أنا كل birthday بديها كتاب. فيا إما هتبقى في ال past يا إما هتبقى في ال future. I'm going to give، إن أنا عاملة حسابي كده I planned that I'm going to give my mother a book for her birthday. أو I gave her a book for her birthday. بس الأصح تقريبا غالبا هتبقى دايما الفيوتشر في الجملة دي، لأني ما عنديش signal word تقول لي إن ده حاجة في الباست. At the age of 23 she become a doctor. She will become a doctor. هي حاجة يعني هتحصل، ما فيهاش تفكير يعني. I knew the answer yesterday. I have yesterday. He told me that he lived in Toronto. That he lived في الباست. يبقى أكيد he told me in the past. We lent Jihad 30 pounds to go home. ما ينفعش أقول lend وإلا هيبقى دي habit، إن أنا كل يوم بنسلفها 30 جنيه، فهي أكيد غالبا في الباست. We lent her. She drank too much coffee yesterday. Here I have yesterday as a keyword that determines the tense of the sentence. Now, this part deals with vocabulary. These words are important, are very important for you as a student in the Faculty of Commerce. الكلمات دي مهمة جدا ليك كطالب في كلية التجارة لأن هي ليها علاقة بالدراسة. These are job titles. دي أسماء أو عن أسماء دي ألقاب. title هنا بمعنى لقب مش عنوان، يعني ألقاب لشغلانات مختلفة. receptionist أكيد حاجة لها علاقة بالreception، صح؟ بنسمع كلمة receptionist دي كتير. What is a receptionist? Yes, a receptionist sits in the lobby, answers phone, calls and greet visitors. الreceptionist اللي هو اللي موظف الاستقبال عادة في الفندق مثلا أو حتى ممكن في المستشفيات، هو موظف استقبال عموما يعني أو في أي شركة. sits in the lobby، فيقعد في اللوبي بتاع الأوتيل أو الشركة. answers phone، بيرد على التليفونات phone calls. and greet visitors، ويرحب بالزائرين. accountant. accountant. what's an accountant؟ accountant يعني محاسب. accountant يعني محاسب. runs the company's financial أو لا an accountant keeps the accounts in the finance department، هو اللي بيشرف على الحسابات في القسم المالي. finance director، director دايما بمعنى director زي manager الاتنين معناهم مدير. finance يعني مالي، ف finance director يعني yes مدير مالي. So a finance director is responsible for what? Yes. He or she runs the company's financial affairs. يعني ايه runs؟ runs يعني يدير مش يجري هنا، يعني verb to run عموما معناه يجري بس هنا معناه يدير، فيدير الشؤون المالية الخاصة بالشركة. So a managing director, yes the answer is managing يعني بيدير، director مدير، فمدير الإدارة أو المدير اللي بيقوم بإدارة الشركة. number four the answer will be yes heads a company and is responsible for its running، مسؤول عن إدارة الشركة. number five sales representative، sales يعني مبيعات وrepresentative ممثل المبيعات، فهو شخص مسؤول عن المبيعات. he or she sells the products to customers. customers يعني المستهلك أو اللي هما الزبائن يعني. personal manager، personnel manager sorry personnel manager means what؟ personnel manager is what we know as the HR the human resources. okay personnel manager is responsible for staff matters and hires employees. personnel manager هو مدير شؤون الموظفين. production manager، production يعني انتاج. so production manager heads the department responsible for manufacturing products، المسؤول عن القسم هو رئيس او مدير القسم المسؤول عن انتاج المنتجات الخاصة بالشركة، عن صناعة المنتجات. okay executive secretary، احنا عارفين secretary طبعا سكرتارية. executive يعني تنفيذية. okay does the secretarial work for top management، اللي بتشتغل بقى مع المدير، او بيشتغل ممكن يكون ولا راجل طبعا او ست، مع المدير for top management، الإدارة العليا للشركة. Finally, sales and marketing manager heads the، طالما قلنا manager يبقى head، head يعني هنا الـ verb to head يعني يرقص، بيرقص heads the department that advertises and sells products، القسم الخاص بالدعاية والمبيعات. Okay, more words or more vocabulary about employment. Interview. What's an interview? We all know an interview. Yes, an interview is an oral examination of a candidate for employment. هي المقابلة الشفهية اللي بتبقى مع أي واحد عايز يدخل في شغل معين، اسمها interview. Experience يعني خبرة. Knowledge or skill acquired from work. Experience. Resume زي بالضبط CV لكن بيبقى more detailed، بيبقى فيه تفاصيل أكتر. It's a summary of your education and work experience. بتقول فيها انت خريج مدارس ايه، اتعلمت ايه، اخدت كورسات في ايه، اشتغلت فين. This is called resume. زي بالظبط CV، الاثنين تقريبا بيستخدموا بنفس المعنى. Staff، remember it is with an A، تكتب STAFF. Staff means people who work in a place. Staff العمل تسمعوها، هم الناس اللي بيشتغلوا في نفس المكان. Staff. Salary يعني of course طبعا عارفينها، مرتب. Payment on periodic basis not on unit. Periodic basis يعني مرتب بيتاخد كل زمن معين، في الأسبوع، في اليوم، في الشهر. Not on unit يعني مش على خلصت حاجة معينة فهديك salary، لا ساعتها مش هيبقى اسمها salary، هيبقى اسمها payment. Number 6, bonus. A bonus is an additional payment to an employee as an incentive or reward. Incentive or reward بمعنى ايه؟ بمعنى مكافأة او حافز. Incentive حافز. Bonus يعني مكافأة او حافز. Fire. Okay, we know fire as in حريق. هل هي هنا بالمعنى ده؟ لا. Fire هنا بمعنى انه يتفصل من الشغل. Fire to dismiss from job، انك انت تتفصل مش انك انت تستقيل. تستقيل يعني quit، quit. Promotion يعني ترقية. Advancement in position in a company. Sick leave. Leave عموما يعني اجازة، فنوع الاجازة دي ايه؟ ممكن تبقى حاجة اسمها maternal leave او اللي هي اجازة رعاية طفل، عندنا في مصر بتبقى عادة للام بس فبتبقى اسمها maternal leave. برا احيانا برضو بتتاخد من الاب فبتبقى اسمها paternal leave. وعندي sick leave، sick يعني مريض، فدي اجازة مرض او اجازة مرضى مرضي. So number 9 will be G. Absence because of illness. Maternity leave لسه قايلينها. Maternity leave. A period of absence from for females when having baby. Retire. You retire أو in Egypt we usually retire when we are 60 years old. يبقى يعني إيه retire؟ Retire yes يعني يطلع معاش. Leave work because of age. Resign زي quit بمعنى يستقيل. Resign leave a job voluntarily، انت اللي بتستقيل مش you don't get fired، you yourself resign. Candidate مرشح. Person applying for a job، لما تروح تقدم على شغل انت بيبقى اسمك candidate، انت لسه مرشح. vacancy يعني في شغلانة فاضية، في شغلانة شاغرة، right؟ غير شاغرة، أسفة. vacancy will be a position to be filled، عندي شغل وعايزة حد يبقى فيه. pay cut يعني خصم، pay cut reduction in the amount of pay. finally wage يعني مرتب زي salary، لا wage payment according to unit not on periodic basis، يعني العمال مثلا لما بيشتغلوا على مشروع معين على حاجة معينة اول ما تخلص ياخدوا فلوسهم، ده اسمه wage. لكن لما بيبقى بياخد كل شهر او كل اسبوع بشكل ثابت ده بيبقى اسمه salary، مرتب. more words and you have the answer key of these words and you can yourself check the meanings of this word from any dictionary. now let's do this revision. the space is the one who runs the company's financial affairs. the answer will be the finance director. number two, when you buy something from a shop you have to take the receipt. excuse me. many years ago I used to sit in the lobby, answer phone calls and greet visitors. I was working as a receptionist. four, the is the one who keeps the accounts in the finance department. the accountant. the accountant المحاسب. five, an additional payment to an employee is a bonus. is a bonus مكافأة. people who work in a workplace are called staff. staff. when someone leaves work because of his old age he retires. buying from wholesale stores is better because it saves money. الجملة، شراء من الجملة. when someone is dismissed from his job he is fired. فصل. I'll wait for the summer discount to buy new clothes because the prices will be reduced. الأسعار هتقل. discount يعني خصم، بس هنا مش خصم في المرتب، هنا خصم في، قلنا خصم في المرتب هتبقى pay cut، لكن خصم في الشراء لما تيجي تشتري حاجة ويبقى عليها خصم بيبقى اسمها discount. in my company I do all the important secretarial work. I am an executive secretary. سكرتير تنفيذي. finally some shops give you a if you are not satisfied with the product you bought they give you a refund، يعني بيرجعوا لك فلوسك. refund. okay and you have the answers here as well. thank you so much. we hope you enjoy the course. it's an easy one and we trust that you will do your best and you will get the high marks. good luck with your exams. bye bye.